The latest now on the worsening oil spill in Oriental Mindoro. Philippine authorities now considering tapping military divers to assess the scope of the damage. Justice Secretary Remulla, who's part of the interagency response team, says they are in talks with the Civil Defense Office for the deployment.
We want divers to come down to be able to calculate the rate of spillage to the ocean to know how much oil is pouring out of the tanker. And we asked the OCD to mobilize some of the divers from the armed forces.
Some 23 villages in Calapan City are now under a state of calamity. Officials say more than 3,000 families in the city are affected.
Meanwhile, Oriental Mindoro is set to begin processing compensation claims for oil spill affected residents. Governor Humerlito Dolor says residents can start to file their claims this Monday. He appeals for patience, though, with the processing of claims seen to take up to a month. The province estimates at least 30,000 families have been affected by the disaster.
Hindi po kinakailangan dumagsak sa Kapitolyo simula sa Lunes. Maaari pong hintayin nyo na lamang ang pagtatayo ng claims office sa inyong lugar. Ito po'y panimula para lamang siguraduhin na sa pakikipag-ugnay ng pamahalaang panlalawigan, ang inyo pong mga claims for compensation sa mga damages ay magkakaroon na po ng katotohanan.
The Philippine Agriculture Department assures the public the smuggled sugar set to be sold in Kadiwa stores is safe for consumption. The agency plans to sell around 80,000 sacks of sugar confiscated by authorities in recent weeks. Agriculture spokesperson Christine Evangelista also says monitoring in ports has been intensified to prevent smuggled agricultural products from entering the country.
Yan po'y dadaan sa mga test, kaya po kasama pa rin natin ang Sugar Regulatory Administration, because as the regulating agency po, we have to ensure na we are very, very sure na ito po talaga ay safe for consumption. So hindi po naman po ito basta-basta na ibebenta, meron pa rin pong food safety protocols na ating i-observe.
Meanwhile, Congressman Arnolfo Teves Jr.'s lawyer challenges the accusers of his client to prove their allegations in the proper forum. Let's get more details from our correspondent, Vivian Guria. Viv?
Hi, the lawyer of Negros Oriental 3rd District Representative Arnolfo Teves Jr. challenges those hurling accusations against his client to prove them in the proper forum. Attorney Ferdinand De Pastra said allegations should be raised before a criminal investigation agency or the ombudsman instead of Congress. The camp of slain Negros Oriental Governor Roel de Gamo said it is considering filing an ethics complaint against Teves over the latter's alleged links to numbers game like small town lottery and isabong. According to the lawyer of the Gamo family, attorney Levito Baligot, this is a violation of Section 14 of Article 6 in the 1987 Constitution, which he added could serve as basis to expel Teves from the House of Representatives. De Gamo's widow, Pamplona Mayor Janice De Gamo, also claimed that Teves was involved in some 20 to 30 killings in Negros Oriental. Janice De Gamo sent a letter to the House of Representatives calling for Teves' expulsion, citing the complaints he is facing over alleged illegal possession of firearms and a 2019 killing in Negros Oriental. House Security or Secretary General Reginald Velasco said the letter could eventually be referred to the House Committee on Ethics and Privileges. Should it happen, De Pastra urged the committee to give Teves a chance to be heard. Meantime, the camp of Teves also asked the House Committee on Ethics and Privileges to defer the implementation of the sanction on the lawmaker. That's at least until they hear Teves' explanation and his continued unauthorized absence from the House of Representatives. The lower house unanimously voted on Wednesday to slap a 60-day suspension against Teves over disorderly behavior. In a letter emailed to the committee on Friday, Teves' lawyer appealed that the suspension be lifted and Representative Teves be allowed to participate in the sessions and discharge his duties as member of Congress virtually in the meantime. The Pasha asserted Teves did not disregard Congress's authority, as shown by his request to extend his travel clearance and later his plea to go on a leave of absence. But these were not granted. Delta Pasha says Tevez requested to participate in the committee hearing via video conference due to alleged serious security threat, which was also disallowed. Back to you.
Thanks, Bev.